So, folks, I think I want to talk about bipolar disorder too, and more of what it is exactly. And I probably will be reading off websites because if I don't, I'll ramble around like I tend to do. I don't go off tangents, but I just ramble. But anyway, here's how bipolar disorder two, and according to a website, it says bipolar two order two is less severe than bipolar two or bipolar blech. Bipolar type two disorder is less severe than bipolar type one. And see, now that I kind of debate because, I definitely don't lose touch with reality and have psychosis when I'm hypomanic or manic, whatever you want to say, because the line is kind of blurred on that for me. But I debate that because, when I get, I think everyone's seen me horribly, severely depressed. I mean, we've seen that. I mean, I was more in my depressive episode until I started rapid cycling like a bitch, But I was more, prone to the depressive episode, and they are very debilitating and severe, and so that's why I kind of debate that because you're thinking about suicide. I mean, that's not fun, So that's why I say I kind of debate that the severity. Although the manic phase is definitely more severe in bipolar one, but anywho, elevated mood. You may have an elevated mood, irritability, some changes in your functioning, but generally you can carry on your normal daily routine. Instead of full-blown mania, you have hypomania, a less severe form of mania. And bipolar 2 disorder, periods of depression typically last longer than periods of hypomania. So that's what they kind of say. And it's more or less true. Depression episodes are more longer than hypomania. And you don't go full-blown hypomania. And I think the reason I said the reason is because I don't drink, I don't do drugs, and I get my sleep. Even when I was bouncing off the ward, I always got to 5 or 7 hours of sleep. No, 7 or 9 hours of sleep that I need. So I think that's why I'm kind of more level. And it is true. For me, it is true. Like, I could still get things done when I was bipolar. I could still get things done even when I felt like horrible crap, which something I did miss classes because I couldn't get out of the bed. But I still like going to work and, things that I have to do, I still got them done. I mean, it was incredibly difficult when I was hypomanic, when I was depressed, but I got them done. And then say if I could work when I got home, then I would crumple in. I could, but it took a lot of energy to keep it together. And when you're hypomanic, for me, I mean, I just, you've seen it too. A lot of I, you've seen it. And it just makes things easier. Unless I could really, I think, to that other level when I'm just, oh, I can't sit still. Or like I have to do something. It feels like ants are crawling all over me. Oh. But anyway, here are some of the symptoms of the hypo. No. Well, here's mania symptoms. Euphoria. Yes, I do get like that. I do get and just experience incredible happiness. I mean, for me, sometimes it feels like I'm connected to the world and I can just feel every little thing. And it's like a great feeling, like I'm at one with the universe. So yeah, inside your self-esteem. Oh yeah, I mean, I still, when I'm normal, I still kind of have an ego, but. Man, that goes, when I'm hypermanic, it goes through the roof. I think I'm the greatest thing in the world. I have like a Superman complex, so to speak. I think, everyone should cater to my every whim. That's, yeah, so yeah. Poor judgment. Sometimes. I'm typically very good at controlling impulses, but sometimes they slip. Like, I mean, oh my God, like I had this idea. Like, I almost gave myself a mohawk, like, when I was like that before. And, I had like the razor and stuff, and then I'd like, no, I can't do this. What am I going to say at work? And so I kind of, but you'll have impulses like that. Some are good, some are just stupid. Rapid speech, yes, I do have that as well. My mother actually confirmed this, and everybody that, my brothers and stuff like that that I have more contact with, they say that I will talk faster than I do, and they can barely understand me. So that happened. And the reason that happened is because my mind goes so much faster that I feel like I had to talk faster. Aggressive behavior, that's also kind of true as well. Because, I will get really irritable and pissy. I mean, I think it was like Thursday, I was had a depressive, I wasn't really depressed, but it wasn't like. The ability, it was more like I just felt depressed. I just felt really tired, but I was so irritable as hell. I mean, everything annoyed the hell out of me. This chair that I'm sitting on annoyed me. Going outside annoyed me. Seeing my psychiatrist annoyed me. Going on that bus and seeing all those people just annoyed the hell out of me. I mean, everything. So, yeah, it's true. Physical activity, yes. Yes, that's true as well. That happens. You know, like I can't, sometimes I can't sit still. Spending sprees, unwise financial choices. Like for me, it's not as extreme as some people. Some people go overboard. For me, I'm a cheap bastard. But for me, like say spending a t my some type of money, for me, something that's overboard. Like I know sometimes I will buy a little more things off eBay that I should. So that does happen. Increased sex drive. Now that's never really happened. Although I do get like my libido does go up, I will say. But yeah, so that kind of sometimes for me, decreased need for sleep. Also happens for me as well, like this is a mania symptom, and like for me, I always make sure I get 7 to 9 hours of sleep. Even sometimes it's incredibly difficult. I will lay in bed closed with my eyes closed, and it will sometimes it will take anywhere between 1 hour to 3 hours, but I will get to sleep, and I will not get up till I have slept 7 hours. Once I'm asleep, bam, I'm hard to wake up. But I will say that it's like I feel like I don't need sleep, and I'll have like this sense of urgency. Like, no, I have to do this, I have to do that, I have to do that, I can't go to sleep. Oh, I'm gonna miss something. And so, you know, it's definitely resistant. Easily distracted. Yeah, I am very easily distracted. I mean, like when I was in my counselor's office, you know, she noticed I was distracted by the lamp, by her hat, by something on the bottom, oh, by the ambulance noise. And yeah, just, yeah, it is. Careless or dangerous use of drugs or alcohol? No, I don't do that. Frequent absences for school or work? No, I don't do that. You know, I still can get things done. Poor performance at work or school? No. Delusions or break from reality? No. So I don't have that. Now, when we go to the depressive phase of bipolar disorder, look at some of the symptoms. Sadness? Oh, God, yes. Oh, man. And like I said, you guys seen that. Hopelessness? You guys seen that in my when I put that video of bipolar depression. It's sadness, yeah. Hopelessness, yes, he's seen that as well. I mean, it's really hard to be motivated. It's just, yeah, that happens. Suicidal thoughts and behavior, yes, that happens. I cannot tell you know, just wanting to jump in front. Even when I was in Pittsburgh, I see seen a bus and just wanted to jump in front of it or throw myself on train tracks. And so it does happen, you know. Anxiety, you know, yes, as well. Sort of, but not extreme. You know, like I will kind of don't want to be around people. I'm gonna get anxious that they'll find out that I'm depressed, or you know, guilt is another thing that yeah, I will for some reason I'll feel tremendously like a terrible person, like I've done something wrong when I haven't, you know, or like I'll just feel bad for some of my past behaviors to people, and we've seen that as well. Sleep problems. I don't have trouble falling asleep. I will sleep way too much. I'll sleep like 10, between 10 and 12 hours. I'll sleep a lot. Fatigue, that's another one. Like I like the last time I just felt really tired, and there was no reason. I got 8 hours of sleep, I should be fine. So that happened. My appetite again, it just goes down the toilet, like ugh. And even when I'm in the manic phase, I don't want to eat because I think it's a waste of time. But yeah, problems concentrating, that yes, because something like what did you say, sometimes but not extreme. Loss of interest in activities once considered enjoyable. That's definitely true. Like, I remember when I was depressed, I did not even want to go to my comic book store. It just felt like a chore, and it was not interesting. I would lose interest in video games and all kinds of things. Irritability, I already said that, yes, that also happens. Chronic pain, no. Absence from school or work, not frequent, but I've missed, you know, school because I just couldn't get out of bed. I didn't want to do it. So that happens. And but I never had a poor performance in school or work. Social situations, yes. But that's kind of the gist of bipolar disorder. I just kind of felt that I wanted to kind of go over it a little bit. But also, it's not just mood changes. It's not just extreme happiness to extreme sadness. It's not just that too. I mean, you got other things that happens, you know. Like sometimes you'll have insomnia and you'll be normal. You'll feel normal and you'll just have insomnia. You can't go to sleep. You know, so that's another thing. And it's not just that too. You forget also the anger and the rage that sometimes comes with it. Sometimes I'll just have I'll have an unwarranted anger and rage for no reason whatsoever. You know, and it's like, ugh, it's terrible. You know, it's like, and it's just I won't understand it. But you know, it's not just like I said, it's not just extreme lows and high. You know, sometimes you'll have mixed episodes. Like you'll feel both, and that's kind of. I think that's happened to me before because it felt like sometimes, you know, I was being pulled in two different directions. Like I was really irritable and pissy, but at the same time I had a lot of energy. Or other times where I just didn't want to do anything, but at the same time I wanted to do something. You know, it's weird. It's a really weird feeling, and that's not fun. So that you forget, people forget about that as well. You know, and also, just to clear up some misconceptions about it, you know, just because you take medication, you'll take medication, it just affects your mood. It doesn't change your personality. You know, people would think that, you know, oh, he's on medication, he's going to be normal, and people know me, I'm not. You know, people would think, oh, you know, you're normal, you know, oh, you know, you're going to act just like God, you're going to behave. It's like, no. And, you know, it's like, no, that's not the way it goes, no. You know, I'm the same person. I'm just, my mood's just a little more stable. And that's it. And, you know, it doesn't change my personality. I'm still this weird, eccentric guy. You know, that's one misconception. Another misconception is that medication isn't all ends be all. For me, it's helping, as you can tell. But for some people, they're resistant to it. Other people don't need medication. They can manage it on their own. After maybe a few years, they can manage it on their own, you know. For some people, you know, even with medication, you still have some tendency, some symptoms. Like, I know that even, like, right now I'm fine, but even I will have, like, that really bad day where I get up and it's just not happening. I am horribly depressed and I'm suicidal for no reason. And then other days I will get really amped and hyper for no reason. But the thing about it, though, it's there to make it more manageable. You know, it's kind of like diabetes. People take insulin. It doesn't eliminate the thing. They might, you know, but they still have to be careful and they still might have symptoms. It's kind of the same way. You know, another thing is that, you know, another misconception is I'm human as well. People with bipolar disorder like myself, we're human. We also have emotions. You know, we can have emotions. We can be happy and a little hyper. We can be sad and a little depressed. You know, we can get angry. We can have normal emotions as well. That doesn't mean we're having an episode. You know, that's another thing that people kind of misconceive, you know, that I'm finding. You know, people misconceive that. And I'm not having an episode, you know. That's just me. I'm allowed to have normal emotions. It's only when it's kind of a little more long-lasting and more extreme, then, yeah, that might be a problem. But, yeah, I just kind of wanted to discuss it a little bit, you know. You have your, you know, bipolar 1 has, like, psychotic features and they way off. For me, you know, it's like you have your depressive episode, you're down. You have your, you know, manic to hypomanic state, which I will get in. And it will last anywhere between a few days to a few weeks. You will have your mixed episodes thrown in there where you kind of feel like you're being pulled in two different directions. You know, and another thing is just because, you know, you have your episode, you will have a normal period. You know, you will have periods where you're normal, where you'll feel stable. Unless, like, for me, I was rapid cycling like a bitch. And so the longest normality that I had was like in 2 days. And then, bam, back to here, back to there. But, yeah, I just wanted to kind of give just, you know, my take on it. And also kind of wanted to give you a little more education on it. Which, you know, like I said, I still don't fully know, you know, 100% what it is. I'm still kind of new at this. So, thanks for watching, folks.